Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have top stories. We are tracking for you on Friday, the 2nd of August. Four people found alive in India's landslide hit Wayanad. Cloudburst wreak havoc in Himalayan region. Soaring inflation worries Pakistanis, essential food items remain out of reach. And Bangladesh teachers protest over death of students in anti-quota protest. And now for all the details, torrential rains in India have caused widespread destruction and left hundreds dead. As the rescue operations entered fourth day in the landslide in Wayanad district in Kerala state, at least four people were found alive in a house and were rushed to the hospital. The death toll has crossed 300 and hundreds are still missing after multiple landslides, sending torrents of mud, water and tumbling boulders downhill, buried or swept people away as they were asleep. Rescue teams have deployed additional forces, including swimming experts. It is the worst disaster in the state since deadly floods in 2018. Meanwhile, multiple cloudbursts in parts of Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand have led to flash floods that have killed over a dozen people. At least four people died in Himachal Pradesh state and nearly 50 were missing in rain-triggered floods. Meanwhile, in the neighbouring state of Uttarakhand, at least 11 people died. Some climate experts have attributed the extreme rainfall, flash floods and deadly landslides in the mountains of India, Pakistan and Nepal to climate change.
अभी 49 के करीब मिसिंग है पर और भी कुछ सूचनाएं आई है लेकिन भगवान का शुक्र है कि पिछली रात से कोई क्लाउड बस्ट नहीं हुआ है और आज थोड़ा सा मौसम खुला है तो और युद्ध स्तर पर हम इस कार्य को कर रहे हैं.
And India on Thursday summoned Sri Lanka's acting High Commissioner to protest following in collision between one of its fishing boats and a Sri Lankan naval vessel that killed a fisherman with second missing. In a statement, India's Foreign Ministry spokesperson said the government of India has always emphasized the need to deal with issues pertaining to fishermen in a humane and humanitarian manner. Existing understandings between the two governments in that regard must be strictly observed, the statement said. The collision took place 5 nautical miles north of Kachathivu, an island at the focus of contention between the neighbours. One of the four fishermen on the boat died and another was missing, while the rest were brought ashore, authorities have said. Lankan Foreign Minister Ali Sabri, talking to Reuters, said Colombo did not want any escalation of the issue and was looking to work with India for a solution. Moving on, soaring inflation has continued to grip Pakistan, with prices of essential items skyrocketing and leaving millions struggling to make ends meet. The government's recent IMF deal has only added to the public's woes, a report.
People across Pakistan are worried over frequent price hike of essentials, including food and electricity, that have made survival difficult. Locals in Karachi city lamented the government has failed to provide any relief so far and only adds to their woes. Pakistan struck a $7 billion IMF loan deal in July that includes tough measures such as more taxes on electricity prices. This has aroused concern among poor and middle-class Pakistanis, contending with the threat of further inflation and higher taxes.
अब ग्राहक भी परेशान हो रहा है, बेचने वाला भी परेशान, लेने वाला भी परेशान. एक दिन टमाटर हो रहा है 120 रुपए किलो, दूसरे दिन टमाटर हो रहा है 200 रुपए किलो. अब लेने वाला भी परेशान, बेचने वाला भी परेशान.
गवर्नमेंट ने पहले ही जो है ना बिजली के चार्जेस इतने ज़्यादा बढ़ा दिए कि एक यूनिट पे वो कभी 30 रुपए बढ़ा देते हैं, कभी 25 रुपए बढ़ा देते हैं, कभी 10 रुपए बढ़ा दें. हालांकि खुद तो वो फ्री में इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं लेकिन आवाम के लिए जीना मुश्किल कर दिया. बहुत बहुत ज़्यादा मुश्किल हो रहा है. मिडिल क्लास गरीब आवाम सांस लेना मुश्किल हो रहा है. आप ये समझ लें कि वेंटिलेटर पे पड़े हुए बेचारे ये लोग, अगर इनको ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिला तो ये सारे के सारे एक एक करके चले जाएंगे. और जब ये गरीब आवाम नहीं होगी तो ये जो जालिम हुकूमत है ये भी किसके ऊपर करेगी हुक्मरानी.
Meanwhile, opposition Jamaat-e-Islami party has continued protests near capital Islamabad since the past 1 week to demonstrate against inflation and taxes on energy bills. Reports suggest the government has raised power prices by up to 20%. Officials say the increases were needed to meet IMF conditions.
And dozens of teachers in Bangladesh took to the streets on Thursday to protest over the death of students in the recent violent anti-quota protests. The teachers, led by faculty members of Dhaka University, initially gathered at different points inside the shutdown campus, but later converged with hundreds of students to rally. A squad of paramilitary police forces were on standby as university professors took turns to speak at the rally. Bangladesh has been going through a turmoil in recent weeks as a government job quota reform movement turned fatal, claiming over 150 lives. The unrest is the biggest test facing Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina since she won a fourth term in January elections, which were also marred by deadly protest and were boycotted by the main opposition BNP.
গত কয়েকদিন ধরে আমরা যা দেখছি যে আমাদের শিক্ষার্থীদের হয়রানি করা হচ্ছে, অনেক নিরপরাধ মানুষ বিনা বিচারে গুলিতে মরে গেল। আমরা তাদের বিচার চাই এবং আমরা চাই একটা দলীয় রাজনীতি মুক্ত নিরাপদ একটা শিক্ষাঙ্গন প্রতিষ্ঠিত হোক।
মুভিং অন, মেজর পলিটিক্যাল পার্টিজ ইন নেপাল হ্যাভ রিজন এগ্রিমেন্ট অন কন্টেনশিয়াস ইস্যুস টু কনক্লুড দি ট্রানজিশনাল জাস্টিস প্রসেস অ্যাজ পার দ্য কম্প্রিহেনসিভ পিস এগ্রিমেন্ট সাইন্ড বিটুইন দি গভর্নমেন্ট অ্যান্ড দি দেন রিবেলিয়ন সিপিএন মাওয়িস্ট, The Himalayan Times reported on Thursday. The political parties, Nepali Congress, CPN UML and CPN Maoist Center, have agreed for issues such as interpretation of conflict era cases, relief, compensation, repatriation and justice delivery. According to the agreement, any form of killing will be defined as murder. Families of security personnel who lost their lives will receive compensation, and a similar scheme will be applicable for the injured personnel, the report by the Himalayan Times suggested. Transitional justice has been a long-pending issue in Nepal, which has faced significant challenges in the past, including political interference, lack of resources, and differing views of how to balance justice and reconciliation. And Hindus across northern India thronged temples and offered special prayers to Lord Shiva on the occasion of Shravan Shivratri on Friday. Shivratri festival is considered extremely auspicious in Hindu religion, especially when it falls in the month of monsoon or Shravan. Devotees made a beeline at temples to pay their obeisance to the god of death and destruction and made offerings of bilwa leaves and milk to the lingam, the iconic representation of Lord Shiva. Shiva temples across the country are all decked up due to Shravan. Some devotees also observe fast during the holy monsoon month and eat only root vegetables and fruits. It is believed those who observe fast and pray during this period are blessed with good health and prosperity by Lord Shiva.
और भोलेनाथ का तो नाम है एक ऑर्डर दानी, जिसको बोलते हैं जो मांगो सो पाओ, उससे ऊपर भी भोला बाबा दे देते हैं, इसलिए इसकी आराधना करते हैं, क्योंकि भोले बाबा शंकर इतने दयालु हैं कि कोई भी इनकी शरणागत आता है तो उसको मनवांछित फल अपने आप दे देते हैं।
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.